Today we're going to use an oscilloscope to look at the three different effects that capacitance can have on electrical systems. Hi, welcome to the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff. Earlier in this season, we've been looking pretty much at DC systems. We've looked at resistance, voltage, and current. Now it's time to look at AC systems, and today we're going to look at capacitance. We're going to look at the three effects that capacitors have on your system using an actual capacitor, but capacitance is actually present in pretty much every electrical system, so understanding what those three effects are will help you analyze and diagnose your circuits later on. Our circuit setup today is super simple. We have the wavegen from my oscilloscope running through a resistor, and that's probed with channel one, and then we're going to put a capacitor in parallel with that resistor to see what happens. The first effect that capacitance has on a system is it's going to resist a change in voltage and store charge, according to the formula Q equals C times V. So let's add the capacitor and compare before and after. I'm gonna save this waveform using a reference waveform. So I hit the reference waveform, save, save to R1, and then I'm gonna display it on screen. So when I turn off channel one, you can actually see that waveform there. Now let's turn channel one back on and add the capacitor. And you can see if I zoom in here, this region my capacitor is charging up. It's resisting that step up in voltage. Here my capacitor is starting to discharge. So all of that charge stored up when the voltage was high is slowly trickling out of my capacitor after my source voltage has already gone low. So if you see your system resisting voltage changes or adding some charge back in after the voltage has turned off, you know that's a capacitive effect. And this effect is roughly how switch mode power supplies operate. When the power is supplied to the capacitor, it begins to charge up, and then when it's turned off, the capacitor discharges that energy into the system. And that leads us to the second effect of capacitance, frequency filtering. There's two different ways to look at this. First, let's look at our signal from before. Remember that a square wave is made up of an infinite number of increasing frequency sine waves. When I remove the capacitor, we get a nice crisp edge, but when I add the capacitor, we see that that edge gets a little rounder, and that's because the capacitor is filtering out the higher frequency components that make up that nice square wave. And that's all we have time for this week. We're gonna pick it back up next episode when we look at frequency filtering on a pure sine wave and the third effect that capacitance has on your electrical systems. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel. We have new videos every week. And make sure you download the new ebook, 6 Essential Tips for Getting the Most Out of Your Oscilloscope.